Hey there, it's Brandon from Virtual DJ, back with another tip of the day. Now, in the latest release of Virtual DJ, we slightly changed how to set different real-time stems modes, as well as added an additional one. Now, the developers wanted me to take a minute to explain the option, how it works, and to provide some insights on how you might want to set it. So let's take a closer look. To change the real-time stem mode, go to the Settings area and click on the Options tab. In the search bar, type in Stems Real-Time Separation and the option will appear. Now, depending on your computer specs and video card, Virtual DJ will have already set real-time stems to either always or reduced quality when you first installed the software and it performed the system check. Now, my M1 Pro Mac meets the requirements for real-time stems too, so Virtual DJ has set the mode to always. This means that every single track that I load, Virtual DJ will generate stems to in real time. No preparing is required. Now, the stems generation process will be shown as a secondary waveform in the DEX display area, as well as a status message next to the search bar. Now, the time this takes to complete will greatly depend on your computer's GPU type and capabilities. The next mode is the prepared mode. Now, when set to this mode and you load a track that has been pre-computed for Stems 2, Stems 2 will instantly be loaded and available for you to use. Now, if you load a track that has not yet been prepared with Stems 2, Virtual DJ will then generate stems with reduced quality. And if you enable Stems Control, you will then receive a pop-up window reminding you that Stems 2 is not currently available, and you have the option to go ahead and pre-compute for Stems 2 or continue with reduced quality stems. Next is the reduced quality mode. Now, when set to this, Virtual DJ will compute real-time stems using the older stems engine that you're already familiar with in the older Virtual DJ 2021 version. Now, this setting is best for those of you who don't have the newer high-powered requirements to use Stems 2 in real-time, or don't have the hard drive space to pre-compute. However, we recommend that you consider adding space so that you can take advantage of the drastic quality difference for using Stems 2. Back in the Options window, selecting Fully Disabled for Stems Real-Time Separation basically means what it says. Stems will not be available at all, not even reduced quality. Nothing to show here. And the final mode, which was recently added, is the on-demand mode. Now, when in this mode and you load a track, Virtual DJ will generate stems with reduced quality. However, when you enable any stems control, Virtual DJ will then instantly start computing real-time stems too. However, depending on your GPU, there might be a slight delay between the sound difference of reduced quality and Stems 2. Now, this mode is intended for those of you who do have the proper hardware specs, but do not use Stems Control frequently, but still want the Stems 2 quality when you need it. For example, a mobile DJ who starts events with cocktail and dinner hours, so there's no need for Virtual DJ to generate real-time Stems 2 during that time. However, when mix time arrives, the capability of Stems 2 will be available for you. Additionally, in the Stems Plus Effects Pad Bank, you now have the ability to use multiple effects pads at the same time, as well as change the beat grid slot setting. As you can see, the improved Stems Real-Time Separation option allows you to choose the proper stems mode for your computer, as well as the way you personally use stems. That'll do it for this tip of the day. We hope you found it helpful. If you have an idea you'd like to see in our next tip, email tipoftheday@virtualdj.com.